Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna the struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Yeah.
This Prince song inside my head. Hands up if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time.
Good morning and good night.
It's gonna be alright. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time. It's always a good time. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time.
world's greatest.
Come on. Yeah. The world's greatest.
I am a mountain. I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest. The world's greatest, the world's greatest ever.
Thank you. Please remain standing and join us in the singing of the national anthem. Be seated. Parents, relatives, friends, members of the school board, our administration, our district staff, and most importantly, our graduates, welcome to the 151st annual commencement exercises of the Williamsport Area High School. This event that we call commencement is the formal process of acknowledging that you have achieved academic proficiency and confirm that all the requirements set forth by the state of Pennsylvania and this school district have been completed. Tonight we are here to recognize the culmination of 13 years of academic work and achievement. Every year I look forward to this night and I cherish the opportunity to speak to all of you. In preparing for my remarks this evening, the word resilience kept coming to mind. The definition of a resilience is the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. If someone refers to you as being resilient, they believe you have the ability to work through hard times, learn from them, and grow to be even stronger, which in turn makes you more capable of overcoming hardships in your future. Class of 2022, I believe you are indeed resilient. You have navigated uncertainty of a global pandemic for more than 2 years. You have adapted your learning styles, your face coverings, your hand washing. You have learned new vocabulary such as social distancing, and experience what I can only describe as one of the most politically polarizing times in our modern history. Through all of these distractions, you have managed to keep your eye on your educational goals, and you have emerged tonight poised to receive your diplomas, turn that very symbolic tassel, and be officially declared high school graduates. Oh yes, graduates, indeed, you are resilient. A high school diploma and a newfound level of resiliency is a great start, but recognize it's only a start. Tonight is not about the end, but rather it's about a new start on a fantastic adventure that only you have control of. Tonight, as we recognize your accomplishments, you should take a brief pause, pat yourself on the back for a job well done. Make sure you thank everyone in your life that has helped you along the way, then quickly get back to work. The world that you live in will continue to move and reshape itself at a place that doubles itself every day. Those that are planning for the present by looking at the past will indeed have no future. In 2004, as many of you were first entering this world, Mark Zuckerberg launched Facebook from a Harvard dorm room. And Google introduced the free email service, Gmail. Also in 2004, American Idol was our favorite TV show. Walmart was the largest corporation in the US, and in the opinion of many, was the beginning of the end for the iconic family-owned mom-and-pop stores that your parents and grandparents faithfully shopped at. Today, even large box stores like Walmart are being impacted with the winds of change by online companies mostly controlled by Amazon. Seniors, my point in all this, change will happen. You should not fear it or resent it. The key is to be ready for it, anticipate it, and be willing to accept it. Your ability to adapt to conditions outside your control will be your biggest asset in the years to come. And I believe this class, your class, is perhaps more prepared than any other class before you due to the global events that you have been adapting to for the last 2.5 years. As you leave the stadium tonight, be mindful that your success is dependent on you, not your parents, not your past. Your future solely lies at your feet and your willingness to work hard and take nothing for granted. I recently read Matthew McConaughey's new book titled Green Lights. In this book, Mr. McConaughey describes green lights as those times in his life when he received a green light to proceed with his plans, a push or nudge or some sort of feedback telling him he was on the right path. Equally as important as those green lights are yellow lights and red lights. Those times in your life when you get the message that you should only proceed with extreme caution, or perhaps that proverbial gut feeling that you should stop what you are doing and evaluate the path you are on. Seniors, pay attention to those green lights, yellow lights, and red lights, and be ready to adapt as needed. I was once told that if you want to change the trajectory of your life, you first need to understand that commitment is what gets you started, consistency is what gets you somewhere, and persistence is what keeps you going. Seniors, I am confident that our talented faculty, staff, and administrators have prepared you well and have provided you the tools and skill set to make a positive difference in not only your lives, but the lives around you. I am proud of all of you, and it has been my honor to serve as your superintendent. Always remember, each day is a gift, and each lesson learned is a blessing. Class of 2022, congratulations. I wish you all the luck and happiness in the world. Thank you.
Hold on. I think I'm missing something. There it goes. Hello, everybody. As I stand here today with my fellow graduates, I can finally say that we did it. Come on. But before I begin, I would like to take the time to thank everybody who has helped each of us get to where we are today. From the extremely explorative administration to the educators who go the extra mile for their students, then to the caring and loving support staff and the parents who help without regard, all of you are the reasons that my peers and I can call ourselves graduates of the 2022 class at WAHS. All right. The future is unknown. And as the theme says, your future hasn't been written yet. No one's has. Your future is whatever you make it, so make it a good one. Each of us who will walk across this stage will continue to grow and develop beyond this building. Some of us will go off to college, some to the military, and some straight to the workforce. And as we develop into adulthood, we will all get different opportunities to grow and to flourish in our environment. These opportunities will happen at different times for each of us, but what I do know is that it will always be the right time. Now understand that there will be obstacles. Life is full of peaks and valleys. As a kid that grew up in a single-parent household with five siblings, I can tell you that it's the valleys that really define your peaks, meaning that success is all in how you handle failure. One of my bigger inspirations when I'm in a valley is my favorite rapper, J. Cole. And he said, "To appreciate the sun, you gotta know what rain is." Now let's take a break from talking about the future and let us reflect upon the past 4 years of our lives. Coming up the hill in ninth grade felt like another step toward adulthood. Here, we started to learn a real responsibility for ourselves as we evolved from children to young men and women. Ninth grade was the year that we all found new friends, joined clubs, and participated in different extracurriculars that would build a foundation for our high school experience. But unfortunately, ninth grade was the first and last normal year of high school. As we became sophomores, we were confident about having another great year. This year, we had the choice to join numerous CTE programs and schedule ourselves according to our own interests. The first three quarters of the year was great, continuing the traditions of numerous spirit weeks, pep rallies, and student events. But this would come to a screeching halt, as did the world when COVID hit. COVID quarantine times were some of the best times of my life while being the worst of times in society. During the lockdown, all of us were presented with an opportunity to work on ourselves as individuals. Some of us found new hobbies, and others revisited old ones. Many of us played video games and grew TikTok addictions, while the rest of us took the chance to grow ourselves. But whatever each of us did doesn't matter, because what we did individually was the right thing to do. And if it weren't the right thing to do, we wouldn't be sitting in these chairs today. Coming into the junior year, there were plenty of unknowns. As we weaved our way through hybrid, online, and full-time learning, we started to come together in an effort to bring back as much normalcy as possible. Though mask mandates and COVID protocols prevented us from numerous events, we stuck together and made the best of what little we had. And that's what I loved about this class, our perseverance. At any point, we could have waved the white flag, but no, instead of doing less, we chose to engage more. After so much time in isolation, having a chance to cooperate with our peers sparked an amazingly productive energy that radiated throughout the class. And then we were seniors. Dang, already? After such a hectic sophomore and junior year, we started to settle back into more of a normal setting, where mask mandates were lifted and COVID numbers dropped. This is what we've all been waiting for, the final stretch. People always told me that senior year was the easiest year, but I'd 100% beg to differ. This is the year that all of us had to make huge decisions on what we wanted to do next. And just that thought alone produced a ton of fear within us, the fear of uncertainty. After we have made our decisions, this fear is still present as we have not had the opportunity to see what the future holds. But in order to suppress this feeling of uncertainty, you must come to terms with what is certain. One thing that is certain is that everybody who will walk across the stage took different opportunities to grow themselves and others around them in this building. This is where we have all built our foundation for our adult life to come. And I could not thank each and every one of you for sticking together through such a unique high school experience. And with that, I would like to highlight a few honorable mentions, such as Quizlet, Brainly, Photomath, SparkNotes, for helping us as well. No, but seriously, we have all worked extremely hard to be able to sit in these chairs today. And it is such an honor to be speaking before all of you at our one and only high school commencement. Thanks again to everybody who has supported us each and every step of the way. And as I hang up my top hat and cane for the final time, I can say proudly that it is a beautiful day to be a millionaire. Thank you.
Testing.
Good morning, Williamsport. It's your boy, Cam Sims. Delivering you your last and final morning announcement. Oh, how I'm gonna miss that. A lot of people try to sugarcoat advice that they give to you, but I'm the type that's gonna tell you how it is. This next step in our lives that we're gonna embark on isn't gonna be easy. It is going to hurt. But anytime we change course in our lives, there's bound to be tough times. However, it's through these challenges that we come into our own busted and bruised selves to find out who we really are. As I went through high school, I would look around and see so many people wanted to follow the crowd instead of being their own leaders. And my advice to you is, don't be afraid to create your own way. Don't walk out of this high school trying to walk down someone else's path that isn't for you, because I promise you that it won't work. Trust me, I know what it's like. The path that you choose is meant for you, not your friends, not your besties, but it's for you. It's created for you. Einstein once said that, imagination is everything. It is the preview to life's coming attraction. It all starts with a thought. How do you think that we got to where we are now? If no one ever used their imagination, we wouldn't have light, the internet, cars, or yes, even TikTok. My point is that no matter how big your dream seems to be or what other people think of your dream, it all depends on you. See, we were all given a gift, whether that's being a teacher, an artist, being good at construction, or shoot, it could be raking leaves. Your gift was given to you for a reason, meaning that no one else in this world can do what you can do. Since this is your gift and your imagination, you're the only person who can make it a reality. Like I said in the beginning, you are going to stumble on this journey to your dream. You are going to fail at something. Accept it. If you think you're gonna be perfect in this life, ooh, child, I got some news for you. I understand that it sounds scary to fail, and the unknown is terrifying, but I'm telling you right now to take the risk. As an athlete, I take risks every day. For example, my most recent risk was joining the track team my senior year. And a lot of you know that I played a lot of sports in my life, but I had no idea how to be a member of the track team. I was clueless, right, Steppy? Where you at? I was learning new things every day, and child, it was terrifying. But just like in track, in life, there are going to be hurdles that you don't know how to get over. If you spend your life trying to avoid them, you miss finding your gifts along the way. How are you supposed to discover your gift and be successful if you don't take the risk? All because you're scared of the unknown. Paige got caught. The only way to succeed is to fail. Because once you fail, now you have the opportunity to come back and see what you did wrong. And it can only get better after that. Now, let me tell you my story of taking the risk that planted the seed for my future career. It was my freshman year, and it was the end of the day, and you know, I was just walking down T-Wing to my bus when I saw this paper saying that auditions were being held for the school play. I really wanted to audition, but I was too anxious to walk into that room. Nerves and fear took control, and the worst thoughts were going through my head, such as, oh, they're all gonna laugh at you, you're not gonna make it, yada, 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 yada. Y'all know how the deal goes down. I started to walk out the door and continue to my bus when suddenly something stopped me. This little voice in my head told me just to try and see what happens. What do you have to lose? I ended up auditioning and getting a part in the play Clue as the cop. And people still don't understand this to this day, but that was the beginning of my path. I was born that day. When you're at crossroads on your journey, I want you to remember these things. You don't have to be the smartest or the richest person in the room to become successful or have value in life. Just be yourself in anything that you do. Don't let anyone tell you what you should or shouldn't become. And like I keep saying, take the risk. It's gonna be scary, but trust me, it'll have a positive outcome. And finally, last but not least, now promise me this. When you get knocked down, continue to get back up. No matter how many times it takes. Sometimes you need to feel the pain of defeat to really know what you're fighting for. Believe and trust in your imagination. Your future is not written yet. Remember that. We are all going to do great things. And if you can't see it, just don't worry. Just know that Cam does. Thank you.
Wait. Well, I can assure you, I will not be doing a backflip off the podium. I am impressed. Class of 2022, the night has come. Your future hasn't been written yet. No one's has. Your future is whatever you make it. So make it a good one. For members in the audience, raise your hand if you know what a flux capacitor is. Congratulations, you just dated yourself. Before I begin with my comments, I would just like to congratulate our softball team. Your success this season made all of us proud here on the Hill. Thank you very much for the competition and the pleasure you gave everyone to watch a successful season. Congratulations to our softball players. Graduates, it has been my pleasure to be your principal, but I have three pieces of advice for you to consider as you begin to navigate your future for it to be a good one. One, stay true to yourself. Two, create the environment that is right for you. And three, create more value than you capture. My hope for all of you is that you remember the moment. Remember one thing that you will carry with you from tonight for the rest of your life. To the audience, faculty and staff, If you are a graduate of the Williamsport Area School District, please stand at this time. Thank you. Students, this may be that moment that you remember because you are joining all of them who stood as graduates of this high school. Now, if I may direct your attention to the printed commencement program, there are a few very important honors and awards that have been earned by students in the class of 2022. The first of these is the President's Award for Educational Excellence, which is listed on page 5. Each of these students maintained a B-plus average for 4 years. There are 100 recipients of this award. The honors letter is earned by a student when they achieve honor roll for all 4 marking periods in a school year. I am pleased to inform you that there are 50 recipients of this year's graduating class. Congratulations to those students. The honors medal is a remarkable achievement. Seniors are recognized for their superior effort in the classroom. They are identified by wearing their medal this evening. The following seniors have earned honor roll distinction at the end of nearly every marking period. These students I am about to name earned honor roll 15 out of 16 quarters throughout their high school tenure. Students, please stand and remain standing when I call your name. Kylie Beck, Chase Bauer, Avery Campbell, Matea Dietrich, Bilal Elafiumi, Blake Forker. Stay standing, follow directions. Marlo Jocks, Charles Lundy, Elizabeth Lundy, Nelson McDonald, Camille Nagy, Amanda Palmer, Madeline Schaefer, Lorelei Weaver, and I just wanted to make sure I said Gideon Hopton. Congratulations to these students. You may be seated. The students I'm about to name are truly exceptional and are also honors medal recipients. Each of these graduates has earned honor roll status every single marking period since they entered our high school. When I call your name, please stand and remain standing. Johanna Baker, Owen Berry, Emma Campbell, Amber Hakes, Kaylee Helmrich, Kendall Kelly, Myla Kelly, Matthew Lavalle Harris, Tegan Marty, Roman Marone, Mallory Pardo, Paige Porter, Amelie Robertson, Marina Chappelle, Layla Waldman, Adriana Williams. Congratulations to these students. You may be seated. The Williamsport Area High School class of 2022 boasts 67 members of the National Honor Society, some of who were inducted into the group last year as juniors. The names of these seniors appear in the commencement program on page 6. And we were recognized last week at the National Honor Society induction ceremony. Each senior member is set apart during commencement by his or her National Honor Society stole. The stoles are worn over their graduation gown. If you are a member of the National Honor Society, please stand to be recognized at this time. You may be seated. On pages 7 and 8 in the program, you will find a list of seniors who are career and technical education completers. Each of these students has successfully completed at least 2 years of a CTE program and completed the NACTI exam. Students are recognized by their CTE program and certifications earned during their time at WAHS. Congratulations to all of those CTE completers. On page 8 of the program, we recognize the senior students who have committed to serve in the armed forces post-graduation. As I call these students' names, please stand and remain standing to be recognized. Air Force, Trayon Evans, Prin Sidlick, and Raylin Sittler. Army National Guard, Connor Adkins, Caitlin Allen, Shane Christensen, Cadence Copson, Cameron Nagy, and Dade Splain. Army Reserves, Joshua Steppy. Marines, Emily Hale and Nathaniel Reynolds. Space Force, Matthew Mitsteifer. Thank you for your commitment to our nation. You make all of us at WASD proud, and we wish you the best of luck as you prepare to begin your career in the armed forces. At this time, we would like to recognize all veterans who served in our nation's armed services. If you are a veteran in the audience, please stand. We salute you and thank you for your service to our country. You may be seated, students. On page 9 of the program begins the listing of scholarships and senior awards offered to seniors and totals over $85,000. Students who are listed in this section will need to visit the awards table in the auxiliary gym after picking up their diploma. Once again, students, you will need to visit the awards table in the auxiliary gym following the commencement ceremony. Each year, the Howard Hare Awards are presented to the outstanding senior male and female athletes. They are chosen by the high school's coaching staff who excelled in scholastic athletics at the Williamsport Area High School. The Williamsport Area High School Outstanding Male Athlete of the Year, Charles Cruz III. Please stand. You may be seated, Charles. Our outstanding female athletes of the year are Mallory Pardo and Kaylee Helmrich. Congratulations, ladies. You may be seated. It is also a pleasure to present the coveted Sportsmanship Award to the male and female seniors who throughout their careers in athletics here have demonstrated the very best of sportsmanship. The winner of the Male Sportsmanship Award is Riley Bauer. You may be seated, Riley. And the winner of the Female Sportsmanship Award is Myla Kelly. Thank you, Myla. It is time to present the two most prestigious awards offered by the Williamsport Area High School. The first award is given by the principals of the high school. It is presented to the student who ranks number 2 in the senior class. It is my pleasure to present for recognition the salutatorian of the class of 2022 who will attend Penn State University and the Shriars Honors College, where she will major in biology. Congratulations to Kendall Callie. Please come forward for your award. The teaching staff of the Williamsport Area High School presents its prestigious faculty award to the young man or woman who ranks number 1 in the senior class. Ladies and gentlemen, this young lady is headed to this fall to Shippensburg University, where she will major in biology. Please join me in congratulating the valedictorian of the class of 2022, Johanna Baker. Here's your items. Finally, I'd like to take a moment to recognize a passing of the guard here at our high school. In addition to graduating your sons and daughters, we're also graduating through retirement 6 of our colleagues and friends from this school. We would like to wish Mrs. Debbie Antonetti Hill, Mr. David Gephardt, Mrs. Shirley Laird, Mrs. Carol Porter, Mr. Jeff Robbins, and Mr. Dennis Waddell the very best in their upcoming retirement. Thank you for your dedication and service to our students over the course of your careers. Congratulations to all 6 of those retirees. I would like to also recognize 2 colleagues who are retiring at the end of this month from our school district. Our assistant superintendent, Dr. Susie Bigger, and elementary curriculum supervisor, Mr. John Killian. I would just like to provide some guidance once we get to the awarding of the diplomas. We want to make sure that everyone stays in their seats this evening. We have our photographers on the ground floor near the fence that will be posted to the website that is listed in your program. If you want to take your own pictures, please stay in your seats. If we cannot do that, we will pause the ceremony. Thank you for your cooperation. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you the Williamsport Area Class of 2022.
we go. Before we turn the tassel, take a moment. Think of your favorite high school movie. Our 4 years were nothing like that. And that's okay. Our high school experience is different dramatically from the films on which we were raised. There was no time to get dressed and done up, go to a diner with friends, and casually stroll to school, all before 7:40. There was no way. The Dunkin' line was so long. There was no bursting out into song. There were no locker breaks. Most of you didn't even know you had a locker. But our lives were never supposed to be like the movies. Yet, somehow, we did end up on the big screen of our classmates' computers. The moral of the story in this movie is one of resilience. Our class was not just taught how to solve for X or interpret Shakespeare, but we also learned how to persevere. Let's play the opening scene. Our first experience on the Hill did not begin with us being welcomed by the unfamiliar faces of administrators and faculty, nor by reuniting with the friends we had known since Cochran or Jackson, Stevens or Hepburn like coming, or even Round Hills Elementary. Rather, our film's production was delayed by the warm, damp embrace of mold. As our movie unfolds, remember that the author Tolstoy said that there are only two plots. One, you go on a journey, or two, the stranger comes to town. So, once the air cleared, we started our freshman year journey together. We walked the halls ready and eager to officially be part of the big stage, idolizing the upperclassmen and generally obeying their guidance that kindly suggested we find our way to the back of the student section. We danced with Willy Wonka at our formal, lost our voices screaming to prove our spirit at the pep rallies, and even enjoyed a 3-hour school day sitting in the auditorium thanks to a power outage. We found sophomore year to be the year that we're truly high schoolers, beginning to feel a little grown up. We had found our way around the school and began to narrow our focus in specific CTE programs, AP classes, and our choice of electives. All these efforts were preparing our characters for the real world. Little did we know, there would soon be a plot twist, with our next scene taking place in an unfamiliar setting. A world of issues, unforeseen. A world where we had to look to ourselves for the answers to our problems. Friday, March 13th, 2020. A stranger comes to town. I know no one wants to hear the date or talk about it anymore, but in retelling the story of the class of 2022, that date cannot go unnoted. It was the beginning of what felt like the end. It could not have been more unexpected or abrupt. It was the career fair. The school was lively and optimistic, looking to the future. All while an extremely intense game of tag had been brewing. Then came the Zooms and Schoology, a world turned upside down, or more realistically, turned into a Chromebook. Not quite the silver screen we had anticipated. Through ever-fluctuating forms of education, Zoom, hybrid, Zoom, in-person, Zoom, Zoom, we were now left to make our own way. We had the choice of either to falter or persevere. It is evident tonight which path the people sitting on this field chose to pursue. Through junior and senior years, all we wanted was normalcy, but that word no longer fit the definition. So we adapted to the new reality as necessary to allow for proms and formals, student sections and bonfires, and plays and concerts. We wrote our own climactic scenes and proved that we didn't need Hollywood's magic. We would use our own. We built skyscrapers at formal, went into the woods in spring, and finally walked the red carpet at our premiere. We must remember to always give credit where credit is due. It is not just our individual experience that has shaped us, but it is also the resources and support that our school provided. Resources like our technology, art, theater, music, and athletic programs allowed us to flourish. We had teachers whose support extended beyond the classroom. Now, we are no longer kindergartners sitting around the rainbow carpet on our favorite color square, thinking of what our futures entail. The class of 2022, it consists not just of students, but of leaders, entrepreneurs, comedians, mechanics, athletes, artists, bakers, contractors, healthcare workers, soldiers, and so much more, all of whom comprise our cast. We work together to create a high school experience unlike any other seen before. It is now time to let the credits roll. Reminisce about your favorite scenes and build excitement for the sequels. We are the future, not just in our own individual prospects, but in helping to define what the world will be. So, let the world see what we have already made together. It has been my honor to be your class president. Thank you.
Good evening. I am kind of what stands between you and your diploma. So, as Coach Smith reminded me tonight on my way up here, that 20 years ago, I was sitting out on the bleachers. 20 years, holy cow, I felt old. Not only did I have a birthday this week, which I didn't feel old with that, but I felt old when she said 20 years. So with that, parents, family, and friends, and most importantly, graduates, I'm going to be quick. On behalf of the Board of Education, it is my honor and privilege to congratulate the class of 2022. What a ride it's been. We've all learned to be flexible and resilient, but you know what? Here you are. What an important milestone to be celebrated. Congratulations. And thank you to all those in our audience that have supported our graduates on this journey. Here are just a few thoughts for all of us to live by. The author's unknown, but the words hold true meaning. Be patient, be kind, smile, have fun, act silly, and giggle. Be present, enjoy today. Bestow grace, practice gentleness and kindness. Be honest, be thankful, live generously, imagine, dream, explore, and learn. Persevere, be courageous, pray boldly, encourage, be uplifting, comfort the broken, serve faithfully. Honor one another, forgive quickly, value family, hug, hope, create. Cuddle, laugh, call out the beauty, choose joy. Sing delightfully, dance freely, work hard, rest well, pioneer great adventures, live with intention, but above all, love your God recklessly and others richly. and knowing that you are all deeply loved. As Emmett Brown from Back in the Future Part 3 says, your future hasn't been written yet. No one knows your future is whatever you make it. So let's make it a good one. So, to the class of 2022, and all of us here tonight, we get to write the rest of our story. And what will it be? While it matters what happens while others are watching us, it matters more importantly what others think of us when we don't think they're watching. So to the class of 2022, congratulations. And make yourself millionaire proud.
Kanita Laddie. Kendall Kelly.
Xavier Taylor.
Amelie Robertson.
Mallory Pardo.
Nelson McDonald.
Charles Cruz.
Olivia Holmes.
Jeffrey Beagle.
Elizabeth Lundy.
Bilal Alfumi.
Johanna Baker.
Zoe Knipe.
Paige Porter.
Xaviera Minnick.
Anaya Andrews.
Isabel Boyles.
Connor Adkins.
Emma Campbell.
Cameron Sims.
Lacey Pickering.
Kydrice Burks.
Kana Riley.
Tegan Marty.
Quasir Saunders.
Caitlin Bacon.
Cadence Copson.
Serena Biter.
Adelia Engel.
Matea Dietrich.
Amber Hakes.
Maraid Ferry.
Kenna Peters.
Keith Freeman.
Rashana Santiago.
Elijah Frierson.
Marina Chappelle.
Matthew Garrity.
Madeline Schaefer.
Kaylee Helmrich.
Another easy one. Megan Snyder.
Kendall Hennigan.
Layla Waldman.
Myla Kelly.
Zaira Walker.
Elijah Keys.
Abigail Weaver.
Francesco Marone.
Lorelai Weaver.
Roman Marone.
Adriana Williams.
Atreyu Murray.
Riley Bennett.
Aaliyah Clemens.
Gavin Bowers.
Zakia Colgrove.
Blake Forker.
Haley Fosnot.
Garrett Labor.
Kylie Beck. You got it.
Matthew Midstifer.
Isabel Bonstein.
Charles Lundy.
Maya McDermott.
Jaden Ulmer.
Magali Midstifer.
Maurice Wooden.
Megan Wetlaufer.
James Barler.
Congratulations, James.
Grace Hubbard.
Treon Evans.
Camille Nagy.
Dominic Sendoma.
Kayla Souter.
Riley Bauer.
Ramaya Thomas.
Kaden Keys.
Deontay McDonald.
Kenneth Myers.
Madison Wall.
Cheyenne Bauer.
Caitlin Harrison.
Jeffrey Beamer.
Tessa Jones.
Tarek Cobb Jr.
Aaliyah Benson.
Elizabeth Houseman.
DJ Green.
Bracia Hawkins.
Emily Hale.
Caitlin Herney.
Brock Mayer.
Ella LeMay.
Cameron Nagy.
Kion Wynn.
Pharrell Harris.
Zanaya Brown.
Prin Sidlick.
Karma Lilith Burke.
Emily Reeder.
Caitlin Decker.
Jay Brayman.
Cadence Helm.
Brent Bohozovic.
Ahmed Ibn Johnson.
Colby Petten.
Nathan Steele.
Shimira Thomas.
Kyla Dyson.
Gage Coons.
Jakeem Hines.
Jason Michael Miller.
Marlo Jock.
Caleb Burries.
Brianna Miller.
Josier Dobbs Harden.
Alessandra Ritchie.
Colin Franzine.
Catherine Brew.
Ethan Franick.
Jay Stovler Allen.
Crystal Gonzalez.
Emily Scaife.
Emma Heim.
Riley Shipman.
Sophie Lester.
Isabella Webb.
Jasmine Pabone.
Devin Black.
Brianna Paul Hamas.
Avery Campbell.
Charlie Furman.
Chelsea Dybel.
Mia Rainier.
Evan Fry.
Amelia Kiesling.
Logan Hall.
Amaya Graham.
Raymond Hartman.
Dominic Santo.
Connor Hunsberger.
Joseph Signer.
Emmanuel Pombor.
Sahad Smith.
Abit Sarker.
Caitlin Stugart.
Lillian Silvis.
Dade Splain.
Isabella Splain.
Sean Ciccatello.
Dallas Grease.
Nicholas Gates.
Owen Berry.
Zachary Lavoie.
Braden Bauer.
Mackenzie Allen.
Elizabeth Carter.
Sophie Bittenbender.
Bryn Laudenslager.
Shane Christensen.
Amanda Palmer.
Chase Bauer.
Sebastian Robinson.
Haley Caudell.
Keegan Vanderlyn.
Gabrielle DeReamer.
Ben Schmouder.
Anna Gallup.
Carmen Alexander.
Malachi Watson.
Chastity Marrero.
Demario Bear.
Taylor Mantle.
Zarek Benet.
Lydia Hyde.
Justin Fulmer.
Gianni Minnick.
Steven Straub.
Wade Rinker.
Leandra Bishop.
Jacob Seppi.
Ty Estes.
Kiara Taylor.
Gracie Fisher.
Lajer Whaley.
Brendan Hill.
Evan Adams.
Adeline Hines.
Thomas Aversa.
Gideon Hopton.
Matthew Axe.
Madeline Jacobs.
Benjamin Pennings.
Tavita Calamifoni.
Austin Reese.
Gabrielle Lawrence.
Nathaniel Reynolds.
Avery Weston.
Alexander Weaver.
Malik Octor.
Blake Willits.
Jade Bailey.
Caitlin Allen.
Congratulations.
Nicole Belton.
Madison Kramer.
Ava Bohr.
Brooke Daneker.
Deborah Graham.
Cole Ensinger.
Madeline Gross.
Raylan Sittler.
Matthew Lavalle Harris.
Shamika Johnson.
Ashley Llewellyn.
Dawson Stahl.
Adeline McDermott.
Adriana Woltz.
Elizabeth Petrosky.
Alora Davies.
Adriana Carr.
Austin Haig.
Amir Coleman Graham.
Erica Haig.
Shahira James.
Gavin Johnson.
Danielle Marceller.
Carrie Ann Pleasant.
Olivia Turner.
Samantha Schaefer.
Kaylee Wood.
Rosetta Carpenter.
Koki Masilla.
Kyle Scholler.
Trevor Cipriani.
Logan Barth.
Ella Linhart.
Samuel Brennan.
Madison Moore.
Adriana Brown.
Taysan Mutchler Smith.
Keenan Brown.
Aaliyah Taylor.
Malachi Carpenter.
Michael Flanagan.
Gabriel Gibbs.
Ethan Flieger.
Madeline Huther.
Tyler Grubb.
Jamal Shaw.
Cody Metzger.
Madison Steinbacher.
Demir Sams Glover.
Hold on, honey. Benjamin Stenson.
Connor Steinbach.
Joshua Steppy.
Nathan Tawney.
Logan Tillotson.
Bladen Treese.
Ryan Clokey.
Alexis Winder.
Matthew Jackson.
Megan Ungst.
Joshua Melito.
Nyreek Bassett.
T- Tyler Courtright.
Kaylee Bohozovic.
Austin Daly.
Shaylin Brown.
Joel Philippa.
Abigail Cash.
Mariana Johnson.
Anala Coach.
Countess Lingard.
Naeem Connolly Ali.
Isaiah Longo.
Naomi Cook.
Warren Robinson.
Samantha Cousins.
Dominic Stuger.
Tanner Crow.
Santino White.
Tyler Dixon.
Brett Young.
Azalea Frisch.
Ethan Young.
Destiny Gilbert.
Nathan Daly.
Kyle Grugan.
Emily Bogle.
Victoria Hartraff.
Jalen.
Guys, we'll start when we settle down. Be respectful of everybody.
Jalen Hyman.
Zoe Hassinger.
Grace O'Kay.
James Hill.
Naya Baker.
Kaylee Howlett.
Savannah Grove.
Amaya Kidd.
Amaya Joyner.
Zaire Massey.
Brianna Miller.
Kiana Potopi.
Ronald Morton.
Yeah. Ryan House.
Christian Mumford.
Siasha Robinson.
Peyton Myers.
Kiani Young.
Heaven Trott.
Jalen Shell.
Jump right up here.
So I'm going to read this your part in red, okay?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'd read that?
Just the part in red. I'll tell you when, okay? All right, is everybody ready? Seniors, please stand. School board members, faculty, staff, administration, family, and friends, by the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the Williamsport Area School District's Board of Education, I certify that each member of the class of 2022 has met all the requirements for graduation as outlined by the State of Pennsylvania Department of Education and our district policies. As graduates, you will now have the rights, privileges, honors, and responsibilities pertaining to achieving a high school diploma.
Seniors, you may now turn your tassels.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to certify and present to you the graduated class of 2022. Congratulations. Congratulations.